Here we go with the second period in Calgary, Alberta. A 2-2 game. As the puck is shot in by the Campbell Conference, the Whales come right back out of there. Chris Chelios trying to clear it in. Knocked away by Reinhardt. And here comes Gretzky. Gretzky shoots one wide as it bounced off a stick. John Tinelli tried to get it up. Held in, centered to Krushelnitsky, but Langway knocked it away. And now Tinelli to Bossy. Here's the New York Islander line of Brent Sutter, Bossy, and Tinelli. Puck comes to the point man, Chris Chelios, centered to Sutter, and cleared away by Reinhardt. Now Stevens at the other point, to Tinelli. Now to Brent Sutter, number 21. Coffey tying him up. Puck comes loose, and it's banked off the boards down the ice. Gary Curry clearing it out of there, and back for the Whales, and controlling, and starting out is Mike Ramsey to Mike Bossy. Lowe got to the net to set it up. And now Lowe carries out. His pass off the skate to Gretzky, and the play is called back on an offside. A 2-2 game here in Calgary as the second period gets underway.
Glenn Sather behind the bench for the Campbell Conference. This is his second All-Star game. Last year they lost. 41-year-old coach of the Edmonton Oilers. He's done a tremendous job, Dan, with that franchise. Their sixth year this year, existence-wise, in the NHL.
And a Stanley Cup last spring. Loose puck taken by Trotche, number 19. Brian Trotche feeding it across the line, and the play is offside at the Campbell Conference blue line. From Maine to Maui, you're watching the National Hockey League on USA. Ron Francis and Tim Kerr have scored for the Whales. Marcel Dion and Miroslav Krejčí for the Campbells. It's a 2-2 game here early in the second.
Dan, about only one good body check thrown so far in this game. That was Chris Chelios against Mike Krushelnitsky in the first period. We don't expect too aggressive game. There haven't been majors in an All-Star game since 1953.
They usually stick to hockey. Here's a bouncing puck handled by Lowe, who headmans it now into the center ice area for Howerchuk. Howerchuk trying to move in with Sutter. Dale Howerchuk centers one across. That's knocked down, and now back come the Whales. It's Mike Gartner. Gartner moving it in, center to Trotche. Howerchuk slid back to knock it away. Now into the corner, Gartner. Dropped it back to the point, but Bork had moved up and couldn't hold it in. And the puck comes all the way down to the Whales end of the rink. Scott Stevens to Ron Francis. Ahead to Michel Goulet. He has Tim Kerr with him. Here's Goulet and Kerr in front. And Kerr too well checked by Doug Wilson. Now a Grodnik trying to gut it up. Here's Kerr back in the corner, centered. A big save there by Andy Moog. Off of Michel Goulet. Goulet right in front of that net. Now Marcel Dion, the captain of the Campbell Conference, clearing it onto the boards. Now headman to John Grodnik. And Grodnik moves it into Wilson, but Dion had gone in ahead of the play and was offside at the Whales blue line.
Andy Moog came up with a pretty good save there on Michel Goulet. Goulet was been fed with a pass from Kerr and just let that puck go, but Moog picks it up nicely. Moog, by the way, has the second best save percentage in the NHL, and there's that save that we were talking about off of Michel Goulet.
A 2-2 game as Phil Russell handles the puck and works it out onto right wing. Now Tim Kerr dropping it back. It comes back in front of the net to Francis. Here's Goulet in the corner. Getting it to Francis, to Kerr with a backhander just wide. Moog tried to cover up, couldn't. And now it's a Grodnik headmanning it into the center ice area to Anderson. Glenn Anderson for the Campbell, centered. And a Grodnik deflected that just wide. Here's Wilson at the point, held it in. Russell blocked his shot. And now Ron Francis for the Whales. Into Ray Bork. Paul Coffey at the other end knocking it down. And Reinhardt works it to Coffey as the Campbells move up ice. Here's Reinhardt. Ridden out by Bork into the corner. Now a Grodnik getting the puck. Got it behind the goal. Paul Reinhardt centering one. That's intercepted. And Kirk Muller starts back. Muller on left wing with a shot. And that's handled by Moog. Now Reinhardt flipping it behind his own goal. Number 66, Lemieux centered it. Knocked away by Moog. Reinhardt clearing one. That's intercepted, and Preacher feeds it into the center ice area to Gradin, to Coffey, now to Gradin. Back to Coffey. Coffey centered, oh, and Preacher shot it wide. Timing on that was perfect, but Preacher's shot was off the mark. Mario Lemieux with a lead pass, too far ahead for the rookie Muller, and it's called back because of icing. With the score, the Campbells 2, the Whales 2, will return right after this.
One of the honorary coaches, the French-Canadian cowboy, Guy Lafleur. Guy, this is the most unique All-Star game you've seen?
It is, because everybody was at the banquet last night. It was dressed with cowboy suit and cowboy boots, so it's different, but it was a lot of fun.
Guy, a lot of your fans think you're still going to try a comeback, are you?
No, I won't try to come back. When I decided to retire November 26th, my decision was taken, and I miss the game a bit, but at the forum, they keep me busy.
All right, he's still representing the Canadiens and busy. Dan, back to you.
Okay, Al, and nice to see the flower, Guy Lafleur, honorary captain. Here's Mike Fossey centering one. That's knocked away, and Carlisle shoots it to center ice. Gary Curry now to Gretzky. Gretzky breaking in, shoots. Big save there by Barrasso as he got a stick on Gretzky's hard shot. Centered again, but cleared by Bork, and now Fossey beats Ray Bork. Bork can't get around Carlisle. Now held in, however. Tinelli's shot blocked to Dwayne Sutter. Big save by Moog on Brent Sutter. And then the puck is cleared onto the boards to Gretzky. Both teams with a good chance. Gretzky at one end and Brent Sutter at the other. Now Brent Sutter's pass intercepted by Krushelnitsky. Ahead to Curry. Back to Curry again. A shot. And that's cleared away by Barrasso. Number 21, Brent Sutter shot at the center. Wilson knocking it down. The Edmonton line out there for the Campbell Conference, but now Brian Sutter over the boards as the Campbells change on the fly. Here's McKinnis. One of the hardest shots in hockey. Let a low drive go. Barrasso handle that. And now back the play comes the other way. Trotche to Gartner. Back to Trotche. Brian Sutter intercepting. To Gretzky, but Chelios cleared it away. Now Trotche to Gartner. Mike Gartner moves in, takes the shot. Works in deeper, but then McKinnis got a piece of his shot. And it bounced away. Back comes McLean to Howardchuk. Howardchuk trying to work it to Brian Sutter. Howardchuk centered, cleared into the corner. Now knocked away, and Gartner for the Whales into the center ice area to Bobby Carpenter. Carpenter dropped pass and returned to Carpenter. He skated off by Brian Sutter. Brian Sutter behind the goal, dropping it to Doug Wilson, and Wilson gives it back to Sutter. And the Campbells come to center and dump it in.
Dan, talk about a tenacious line Al Arbor has put together. Bobby Carpenter, Mike Gartner, and his own Brian Trotche. And does that line ever work?
Now, Ogrodnik moving in. Trying to center one. It's grabbed by Barrasso, and he held onto it. And we'll get a faceoff off to the right of that young man, Tom Barrasso. 19 years of age, his second year in the league, and last year won the Calder and Vezina Trophy.
Well, he makes a good save here on Wayne Gretzky right from the top of the circle. And right after that, Andy Moog himself had an excellent save because he was facing that line of Brent Sutter, Bossy, and Tinelli. And Brent Sutter was in a good scoring position.
And an excellent save by Moog. Still 2-2. 12:55 left in the second period. Michel Goulet trying to move it out of there. Gets help from Phil Russell. Stolen now by Glenn Anderson, who centered it, but Tim Kerr comes back the other way for the Whales. Trying to clear it in. Coffey knocking that down. Now shot to center ice, and it's Marcel Dion leaving it for Paul Coffey. Over to Ogrodnik with a shot wide of the net. The target. And now a lead pass to Kerr will go the length of the ice. Moog letting his defenseman Coffey go back and play the puck, and as a result, it's icing, and a faceoff will come back into the Whales' country.
Well, you look at number 7, Paul Coffey from the Edmonton Oilers. This is his fourth All-Star game for the 23-year-old player. He was the only unanimous choice amongst defensemen this year. He has 7 power play goals and is third in scoring for the Oilers. 21 goals already back in that blue line.
Faceoff coming up to the left of Barrasso. One by Dion coming to the point. That shot by at least by Reinhardt is blocked by Barrasso, and now they puck back at the Campbell blue line. Here's Coffey shooting at the center. That's intercepted. Cleared in, and now a centering pass, but Coffey is there to intercept. Reinhardt trying to clear it up. Got it near the line. Held in. Kerr's shot turned aside by Moe. Now on the boards. Goulet into the corner. Gets it to Ron Francis, but Coffey took him in out of the play. And now Anderson feeds it to Dion. Marcel Dion into the corner. Looks to the front of the net. Grodnik is there, but Dion is skated out by Goulet on the play. And now it's Tim Kerr, number 12, for the Whales. Moving it in, and Carlisle is back to get it. Carlisle for the Campbell Conference to Miroslav Krejcer. Now to Gradin, who flipped it in. Knocked aside by Barrasso. And then cleared back to center ice, low knocking that down. And Steve Payne for the Campbell Conference to Krejcer. Scott Stevens knocked it up. Now Payne tries again, shooting one in. Barrasso out of the net to clear it onto the boards. Lowe knocks that down into Krejcer. Krejcer centered, cleared away by the goaltender, and now the puck held into the zone, but now carried into the center ice area. Here's Krejcer feeding Payne. Payne trying to leave it for Randy Carlisle. Carlisle dropped it back, but Kirk Muller intercepts and gives it to Lemieux. Mario Lemieux breaking down, trying to work it in front, but it's cleared by Moog. Now to the point, Chelios a shot. Moog, a stick save there on a low drive. Now into the corner. Krejcer knocked it back of the net, but Muller dropping it in front. Chelios a shot. That hit Carlisle. And now Payne headmans it to Krejcer as the Campbells come the other way. But Chris Chelios is back to get it.
Again, the forwards really have to be alert. You just don't have the luxury on your own team to have six defensemen that can move the puck the way that these players can out here behind the blue line.
Here's Gretzky racing after a loose puck, but John Tinelli beats him to it. And Tinelli to Chelios, who gives it to Brent Sutter. Sutter dropping it to Langway. Number 5, Rob Langway, into the center ice area. Now to Chelios. Chelios for Tinelli. Tinelli got it into the zone, but Doug Wilson is there. And these two offensive teams are doing some very good checking at this point. Here's Fossey. Check from behind, and Doug Wilson cleared it ahead to Krushelnitsky. Krushelnitsky to Yari Curry, now to Gretzky. Gretzky moving in. He's checked, and Langway is there to clear one. And Tinelli comes back for Brent Sutter. Over to Bossy, but a good defensive play by Doug Wilson, and a shot back to center. Very close checking. It's still tied at 2. Brent Sutter trying to hold it into the zone, but the Campbells clear it to center, and then it is his shot back in. It's offside. Here again is Al Trotwood.
Dan, I'm chatting with the sheriff of the National Hockey League, actually the president, Mr. John Ziegler. There was a time when I think people were skeptical that hockey could make it here out west, and look, this is a perfect example of the truth that it can.
Well, it certainly is. I have no question about the franchises out here, particularly in Alberta, Edmonton, and Calgary. Not only have they been great additions to the National Hockey League, they've developed a rivalry that's almost second to none in the league.
How do the people of Hartford follow this?
Well, that's one of the great competitions. Each year we say, how can anybody do better? We didn't think anybody could do better than the one last year, and look what Calgary's done. So people in Hartford will be there.
All right, maybe back to black tie next year. Back to you, Dan.
Okay, Alan, both teams have made goaltending changes. Pelle Lindbergh taking over for the Whales, and Grant Pure now taking over for the Campbells. We just passed the halfway point, and as is the custom, both teams change goaltenders. Now a loose puck cleared in by Coffey. Around on the boards to Reinhardt. He leaves it for Paul Coffey. Coffey firing it up the middle to Howardchuk. Now to McLean, but Ray Bourque is there for the Whales. This pass to Phil Russell. Shot to center. Now stolen, and here comes Carpenter to Gartner. Gartner trying to flip it through. Did into the corner to Trotche. He's checked, and it's cleared by Howardchuk to McLean. McLean to Coffey in this 2-2 game. Shot into the zone, and Ray Bourque, the Boston Bruin great defenseman, back to get it and clear it for the Whales to center ice. I'm surprised to see these two offensive teams checking so well.
Well, they really are. And Dan, defensively speaking, these defensemen out here, give them all the credit, because, I mean, they may be great offensively, but they are so quick, so agile, and so smart, and they can play equally as well behind their own blue line.
Here's a centering pass and a save by Fuhr on that deflection. And back the other way comes Anderson to Dion. Back to Glenn Anderson. Trying to barge through, he does. And a save by Pelle Lindbergh on his first action of this game. And then it's shot to center by the Wales Conference. Knocked down by Kevin Lowe. Now Tim Kerr for the Wales. Sliding it in. Lowe is there for the Campbells to now give it to Randy Carlisle. Here's Carlisle getting a return pass from Anderson into Dion, who shot it wide as he didn't get a stick on the pass properly. Now Ramsey pinning Dion out of the play. Puck still loose in the corner. Dion centered it, but Tim Kerr was there to clear it away. Carlisle at center ice. Shoots it right back in. And going back to get it is Scott Stevens, number three for the Wales Conference. Stevens just leaving it there. And Mike Ramsey stick handles to center. Now to Kirk Muller, the 19-year-old rookie from the New Jersey Devils. Centered one, and Kerr shot right on, and Fuhr, a stick save on that. Now Carlisle to center ice to Gradin. The Preacher returned to Thomas Gradin. Centers to Payne, but that was knocked away by Chelios, who made a good defensive play. Back comes Kerr the other way. Shooting one in. Mario Lemieux, the rookie number 66 of the Pittsburgh Penguins. Back to Langway. Centered it in front, oh, and Hedberg was there, but couldn't get a stick on it. And the Campbells come back, led by Steve Payne, to Miroslav Preacher. That's broken up, and Langway starts back. Here is a pass to Lemieux. He flips it through, Hedberg, and he shoots, he scores! Anders Hedberg! And it's 3-2 for the Wales Conference. And the oldest player in the game, 33-year-old Anders Hedberg, gives the Wales the lead.
Well, a neat little pass by Lemieux, and here goes Hedberg. Just a tremendous deke that Hedberg makes before then going to his backhand. There he goes, totally beating Grant Fuhr. Hedberg with a pass from Lemieux.
Anders Hedberg of the Rangers giving the Wales the 3-2 lead. This is Anders Hedberg's first All-Star game, believe it or not, and he gets a goal. And that's nice to see, because the word is that Anders is probably going to retire at the end of this year.
Well, he has had some damage this year done, Dan, to his retina, and he only has 2200 vision in that eye. And so there is a lot of speculation that this will be his last year. He's playing on a line, by the way, with two first-year players. It's interesting.
Here's Gretzky moving back to Curry with a shot just wide. And now the Wales, who have just taken the lead, got the puck. Brent Sutter to Phil Russell. Russell couldn't clear it, but Bork is there now. Stolen, centered. Russell knocked it away. And back comes Bossy. To Tinelli. Trying to get it to Brent Sutter. Intercepted, and Coffey comes back the other way for the Campbell Conference. Paul Coffey to Yari Curry, but Ray Bork intercepts. And here's Tinelli leaving it for Brent Sutter. Brent Sutter moves in a shot. Fuhr the save on that. Now it's Reinhardt controlling the puck. And Reinhardt cleared it over onto the board for Curry, who shot it to center. Bork has it there. Bork then lost it to Gretzky. Gretzky trying to work it into Curry to Krushelnicki. Shot right on, and Pelle Lindbergh with a stick save. And back the other way, the Wales, led by Brent Sutter. DeBossi, but back-checking was Krushelnicki, and he breaks that up. Now Mike Bossy loses it to Kevin Lowe, and the Campbells have a 3-on-2 break. Curry to Lowe, but the play is offside at the Wales blue line. For our local systems, we'll pause now. It's the NHL on USA. Well, the new goaltenders for the Wales Conference, Pelle Lindbergh, has taken over 46 games this year and 24 wins. At the other end, Grant Fuhr for the Campbell Conference from the Edmonton Oilers. So that's the change in goaltending. Now Trotte moving in. Fuhr away out of the net to make an excellent save. Now Gartner behind the goal to Carpenter, lets it go to Trotte. Trotte flipped it in front. Fuhr the save on a close-in play, and he was able to smother it. It's a 3-2 lead for the Wales, and the place to stay for the All-Star game is USA. 4:41 left in the second period. 3-2 for the Wales Conference, that last scoring play. Hedberg from Lemieux and Chelios, 13:46 to time. And the Campbells from a faceoff in their own zone. Brian Sutter to Dale Howardchuk, number 10. Howardchuk got it through the defense, but Lindbergh cleared it away. Now into the corner. Howardchuk knocked off the puck by Mike Ramsey, number 6. Ramsey to Bobby Carpenter. Carpenter centers, and a good defensive play there by Lowe to knock it down. Carlisle clearing it. Held in at the point, however. Now a shot by Carpenter blocked, and Sutter for the Campbells shoots it all the way down the ice. Mike Ramsey back to get it. Cleared into the center ice area, and Al McInnis chases back for the Campbell Conference.
Well, in a game like this, Andy Van Helman doesn't have to raise his arm for any penalties too often.
They've had just the one. And that was in the first period. Here's a centering pass, but Doug Wilson couldn't hold it in and has to chase back after it. Now over to McInnis. McInnis up the middle to Dion, to Obrovnik, off his skate, and then Anderson a blast. That's high. And back come the Whales. Tim Kerr. Kerr trying to move it in, centered, and that was fanned on in the slot by Francis. And the other way, it's Dion to Obrovnik to Glenn Anderson. Anderson stopped by Langway. Anderson again with the puck. Centered one right through the goal crease. Comes to Wilson. Doug Wilson cutting in. And he was checked. Chelios tried to clear it. Obrovnik held it in. Chelios blocked his shot. Obrovnik holding it in again. Here's Dion. Tried to center one. Knocked away by Langway, and it comes to center ice with Reinhardt back to get it. Over to Obrovnik. Less than 3 minutes to play in the second period. Now Tim Kerr to Michel Goulet. Goulet looking for Kerr, gives it to him, but Reinhardt knocked it away. And Reinhardt feeds it to Gradin. Now to Preacher. Here are the Campbells with Preacher shooting one wide on the short side. O'Pain a drive, and that's off the glass. Now Reinhardt holding it in. Paul Reinhardt, talented Calgary Flame defenseman and sometimes forward. Behind the net to Preacher. Preacher can't center. Here's Hedberg trying to, or Gradin trying to work it in front. He's checked, and the Whales come right back, led by Ray Bourque of the Boston Bruins. Bourque trying to beat it in front. They do. Lemieux shoots and scores! Mario Lemieux, the 19-year-old rookie from the Pittsburgh Penguins.
Lemieux just shoveled that in nicely, but it was Raymond Bourque that brought the puck into the zone, fed it across to Muller, who then returned it right in the middle of the ice surface to Lemieux. Watch this pass by Bourque over to Muller and snapped it right across to Lemieux.
A couple of 19-year-olds combining there. Muller is just 19, and so is Lemieux.
Pretty big thrill for those two players. First year in the NHL, first All-Star game.
What futures? Kirk Muller of the New Jersey Devils and Mario Lemieux of the Pittsburgh Penguins has in this league, just 19, and that gives the Whales a 4-2 lead. Lemieux from Muller and Bourque, the scoring play. 17:47. Now a chance at the other end, and a diving save by Lindbergh, and he smothered it. For our local systems, we'll pause here. It's the NHL on USA.
Slim, Al Troutwig back in Calgary with you at the end of the second period. We'll chat with Tom Barrasso, the starting netminder for the Campbell Conference, and we'll also for the Wales Conference, rather, and we'll also show you how they built the Saddle Dome. Back to you, Dan.
And the Campbell Conference on the attack, but the play broken up by Scott Stevens, and the Wales clear it to center. Kevin Lowe back to get it. Five of the six players on the ice right now for the Campbell Conference from the Edmonton Oilers. Gretzky, Krushel, Niskey, and Curry up front. Low on defense, and Fuhr the goaltender. The only non-Edmonton player is Randy Carlisle of the Winnipeg Jets. Here's Low to Krushel Niskey. Knocked away by Ramsey. Now to Brent Sutter. Carlisle skating him off. Here's Brent Sutter trying to center, but Yari Curry, number 17, has it. John Tonelli in to check him. And now Curry headmans to Gretzky. Gretzky with just over a minute left in the second period, cutting in. Stops. Centered it to Curry, but back-checking was Bossy. Now it's centered again. Krushel Niskey to Curry, but Langway broke it up, and we're in the final minute of the second period. The Whales leading 4-2. Here's Yari Curry dropping it back into his own zone as Al MacInnis feeds it to Doug Wilson. Wilson shot it into the center ice area, but Langway is there to knock it down. And the Whales, who lead 4-2, move the puck up ice. Here is Trotche, but MacInnis is there to knock it away. Now Langway into his own zone to Chelios. Chelios dropping it to Langway. Just 25 seconds left in the second period. Lead pass to Gartner. He moves in and the play is offside at the Campbell blue line. Just 20 seconds left in the period. It's 4-2, the Wales Conference over the Campbell Conference. Play underway as the puck is shot in by the Campbell Conference, and as it is, the buzzer goes to end the second period here. A pair of goals by Anders Hedberg, and Mario Lemieux has given the Wales a 4-2 lead. Shots on goal in the game. So far, the Wales 24 and the Campbell Conference 17. Coming up, the 19-year-old goaltender of the Buffalo Sabres, the guy that started this game for the Wales Conference, Tom Barrasso, visits Al Krupwig in our USA studio. After two periods of play at the Olympic Saddledome in Calgary, the Wales Conference 4, the Campbell Conference 2.
A very busy February for us on USA, and we'll start with back-to-back games next. And as the score at the end of two periods of play is the Wales Conference 4 and the Campbell Conference 2, and the band entertaining a sellout crowd at the Calgary Stampede Olympic Saddle Dome here in Calgary Stampede Park in Calgary, Alberta. Mentioned that game next Monday, Buffalo against Edmonton. In goal for the Buffalo Sabres, most likely, will be Tom Barrasso, who's with us in the studio. Tom, you'll be facing Wayne Gretzky again next Monday night, but first, this first All-Star experience for you, what would you say is best the way to describe it?
Well, the best part to describe it is that the game part's over, and now I can enjoy the rest. It was quite a nerve-wracking thing with all the pregame ceremonies, and it's tough to concentrate with all the extra things going on, and I was happy to get involved and get my part over with, and now it's just great to be a spectator and observing it.
Well, you only gave up two goals, I should say only, because you had Gretzky and the boys facing you. Were you satisfied with that?
Well, you can't be satisfied with two, but it's the kind of thing where they can dominate how well you play. If they want to pass the puck around, they can really make you look pretty bad. And we're happy. We're ahead right now, and you know, we have to be pretty positive going into the third period.
Tom, you must have had some down moments when you were sent down to the minors first part of the season. Does this appearance erase all those negative feelings? I mean, because it's pretty amazing that you're here on the All-Star team.
Well, I think it proves to a lot of people that I'm back on top of my game, and it's a great honor for me to be back here, and I have to thank all the people involved for getting me here, especially my teammates, because without them, I would never have been an All-Star goaltender, and they're the ones responsible.
Well, I don't think anybody counted you out, but would you say it was a testament to Scotty Bowman knowing what to do in a certain situation?
Oh, that's tough to say. You know, it's the kind of thing, there was a lot of controversy whether I should have gone down or not, and you know, it's not my decision. It was his decision to send me down, and I went. I'm back now, and it's in my past. I'm just going to try and leave it there.
All right, Tom, let's look ahead to the game Monday. The Sabres, for a while, couldn't get Scotty that win he needed to reach the top of the list, but now they're playing so well. I mean, they're really the class of the Adams Division right now. Tell me about the team.
Well, right now we're really going strong. I think in our last four games we have about 23 goals, which for us is just fantastic. We had been struggling a little bit offensively, and now our offense has really kicked into high gear, and the defense has been playing well right along, so we're on top of our game. Hopefully we can hold out until the end of the playoffs.
All right, Tom Barrasso, who has survived his test against the Campbell Conference All-Stars tonight. We mentioned earlier that there are honorary captains for both conference teams tonight. We spoke to the Flower before, and now here's a look back at Guy Lafleur. Guy Damien Lafleur of the Montreal Canadiens. He just retired this past November 13th after 13 memorable seasons with Montreal. The league MVP twice. The NHL scoring champion three times. He played on five Stanley Cup winners and was the most valuable player in the 1977 series. He also became the first player ever to score 50 or more goals in six consecutive seasons and an All-Star team selection five different times. Guy Lafleur, honorary captain of the Wales Conference All-Stars here in Calgary tonight. After two periods of play, it is the Wales Conference All-Stars 4 and the Campbell Conference 2. When we come back, we'll talk a little bit about this fabulous Olympic Saddle Dome. Just how did they build it? Al Trotwick back with you on USA. We are a long way from Wall Street, that's for sure. Wales Conference leading the Campbell Conference 4-2. We're in between periods 2 and 3. We've seen all the arenas of the National Hockey League. It is of my opinion that this is the most beautiful. Let's see how they built the Saddle Dome. Back in 1975, the World Hockey Association's Vancouver Blazers became the Calgary Cowboys after their owner transferred the faltering franchise to Alberta. The Cowboys stirred interest in local business circles for the need for a new arena. The 6,500-seat Stampede Corral was not a major league facility. But when the Cowboys continually attracted crowds of only 3,000, both the WHA franchise and the idea for a new facility folded. But then in 1980, Vancouver business entrepreneur Nelson Scalbania bought the NHL Atlanta Flames and moved them to Calgary. 48 hours after purchasing the team, 11,000 ticket requests poured in for the 6,000-seat corral. That event, coupled with the city's prospect of landing the 1988 Winter Olympic Games, gave birth to the design of the 17,000-seat Olympic Saddle Dome. What followed were three controversial and complicated years of design flaws, construction malfunctions, and a cost override that skyrocketed the price of the Olympic Saddle Dome to just under $100 million. But what began in the spring of 81 came to fruition in the fall of 83, a showplace arena for all of North America. Calgary's Olympic Saddle Dome, a living example of civic pride and commitment of the people of this Alberta region. And that is where we are tonight at the Saddle Dome in Calgary, Alberta. Two periods complete in the 37th NHL All-Star Game. Wales 4, Campbell 2.